class, please be seated. Thank you, Mr. Willer and members of the band. Thank you, President Brandt. And on behalf of Woodward Granger Community School District and the class of 2022, I would like to welcome each of you as we celebrate and share in this special occasion. And what a special day it is. Many of you have been dreaming of this moment for your child since the day they came home from the hospital, thinking about what all they might become on the drive home, talking about your dreams, hopes, and fears for the future, pondering how something so small and innocent, strapped tight to a car seat, could possibly turn into such a tall, brave, and independent person we see before us. Some of you still might be checking the program for confirmation that yes, this isn't a prank, this is happening today, they are actually graduating. No matter how you come to us today, enjoy it. Today is a culmination of everyone's hard work and dedication, which is absolutely a reason to smile. We are here to celebrate and honor the class of 2022 because they have earned this moment and they deserve this celebration. But no doubt they've come a long way. Moms, dads, aunts, uncles, grandmas, grandpas, we all have. Recently, my wife and I attended our oldest daughter Cora's kindergarten orientation night. The principal packed all of the parents into the school's cafeteria, and as I sat on this little itty-bitty seat, much too small for my backside, and at a table that I'm not sure was much longer than my arm. As I sat there in that lunchroom, I couldn't help but look around and notice all the looks on the parents' faces. The worry, the excitement, the hope each parent had in their eyes for their child was clear as day. Some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. How will school go for my child? Will they be liked? Will they make good choices? Will they be liked by their peers? What will they grow up to be? I can tell you firsthand that those feelings of nervousness and possibility are very real. And wonder and hope are very normal. The funny thing is that flash forward to today, right now, I'm not so sure this moment is much different. As I look around this gym, I see parents sitting in seats that I hope were a lot more comfortable than mine were that day. But the looks on your faces is eerily familiar. The worry, the excitement, the hope each of you have in your eyes for your graduate is the same. The uncertainty mixed with the optimism about where they may go and what they may do is all the same. So all in all, I'm not sure that that feeling ever goes away. But I do know this. I do know the students that I see before me. The look in their eyes brings me comfort and it brings me hope. This group is resilient. They are determined and they are hardworking. They have survived a pandemic and probably more difficult, a new high school principal. The world is faced with more and more complexities every day, and oftentimes it feels like we have more problems than answers. But I know these students and I know their hearts. Class of 2022, I believe in the power of you. We all do. And I know that whatever comes next for you, whatever life throws your way, you will embrace the moment, you will find the silver lining, and you will work your way out of it because that's what you've always done, time and time again. So families, as you sit in our bleachers today, I would like to take you way back to where this journey all started. Way back to the beginning. I want you to imagine that you're transported back into the elementary school cafeteria, into those tiny little chairs surrounded by that tiny little table on a warm May evening. Maybe even go back a little bit further. Let's go back and let's start off by seeing where all of this started. Mr. Churchill.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say, as it was. got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night, let's live it up. I got my money, let's spin it up. Go out and smash it, like oh my god. Jump out that sofa, let's kick it off. Fill up my cup, mazel tov. Look at her dancing, just take it off. Let's paint the town, we'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof,
and then we'll do it again.
Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. And do it, and do it,
let's live it up.
And do it, and do it, and do it, do it, do it. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it. Cause I got a feeling, ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling, ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night,
hey,
let's live it up,
let's live it up.
I got my money,
hey,
let's spin it up,
let's spin it up.
Go out and smash,
smash it,
like oh my god,
like oh my god.
Jump out that sofa,
come on,
let's kick it off. Fill up my cup,
drink,
mazel tov. Look at her dancing,
move it, move it.
Just take it off. Let's paint the town,
paint the town.
We'll shut it down,
shut it down.
Let's burn the roof,
and then we'll do it again.
Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it,
let's do it.
And do it, and do it. Let's live it up and
do it,
and do it,
and do it,
do it, do it. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it,
do it,
do it, do it. Here we come, here we go, we gotta rock. Easy come, easy go, now we on top. Feel the shot, body rock, rock it, don't stop. Round and round, up and down, around the clock. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday to Sunday. Get with us, you know what we say, say. Party every day, party every day. And I'm feeling, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good
I need to thank a few people for making this event possible. Bringing this commencement to our gym is a very large undertaking and would not be possible without a team of dedicated and special people. First of all, a big thank you to Alex Mayerhoff for creating that lovely slideshow. Thank you to my assistant, Beth Griffin, for her organization, communication, and hours of work spent putting this event together. Thank you to Scott Chapman for working with members of our senior class and their families to give them a voice in today's ceremony. Mr. Chapman does so much behind the scenes to make sure everything is perfect for our students. Thank you. Thank you to Cody Churchill and Troy Smith for their assistance with logistics in the live stream today. And a very special thank you to Dave Smeltzer, Virginia Polich, Kibby Kavanaugh, and our custodial team for the planning and setting up of this event. These are all great people who went above and beyond to make sure our seniors could have this special day. I would also like you to join me in thanking my amazing teachers and support staff for their unwavering support and dedication to our students. Staff in attendance today, can you please stand to be recognized so that we may all thank you for your selflessness, your lovingness, and there's just not enough we can do to say thank you for all of the time and effort that you put into getting our students here today. Could you please stand? At this time, I would also like to introduce our distinguished guests that have joined me on stage today. They are my admin team, Mr. Matt Bruman, Mr. Jake Moling, Mr. Matt Eichhorn, and Ms. Becca Moss, Superintendent Dr. Matt Adams, School Board President Mrs. Ashley Brandt, School Board Members Sam Behrens, Tim Bogardis, David Elliott, and Troy Jansen. Today, we will honor 60 graduates, and as the principal of Woodward Granger High School, I would also like to say thank you to all of you. This is my first year here at WG, and despite all the ups and downs that come from a transition in leadership, this group has continued to show a positive attitude, patience, and resilience through it all. On the field, on the stage, and in the classroom, thank you. Thank you for leading the way and setting a great example for our future graduates. Your passion, your empathy, and your enthusiasm has had an impact on us all. You are everything I could have hoped for. Over the last year, our school district has started the process of defining what type of student we hope to graduate from our district. We've settled on 5 traits that I believe exemplify our hopes and dreams for our students perfectly. Communicators, critical thinkers, innovators, resilient and impactful individuals. These traits transcend any generation, culture, or career field. And when our students demonstrate those 5 behaviors, we all know that we've done a great job raising our kids. I want to keep those words in your mind as we acknowledge all of our students. Specifically, we have 4 students that will be speaking today that I believe embody all 5 of those traits perfectly. In what has already been a banner year for our student body, I'm proud to recognize all 4 of these speakers as the valedictorians of their class. When you hear each of their stories and listen to them speak today, you will undoubtedly understand how all of them are considered top of their class and deserving of the title valedictorian. It is my pleasure to start today's speeches by introducing 3 of our valedictorians on stage. Our first valedictorian is Mackenzie Dresbeck. Mackenzie has received a perfect 4.0 GPA, but if you know her, you know that that perfect grade throughout high school is hardly her greatest accomplishment. In addition to her grade point average, Mackenzie has also earned her CNA at DMAC, voted president of student council, National Honor Society member, helped start our building safe driving program, earned her silver cord, all while participating in 3 varsity sports. Mackenzie will be attending Luther College for nursing and to run cross country. Our next valedictorian is Chloe Hogue. Chloe has received a perfect 4.0 GPA while participating in countless activities and working a part-time job. Chloe has played softball, track, cheer, cross country, and is a wonderful singer in our choir. She was voted team captain of the track team 2 years in a row, and she is the 2022 Governor Scholar Recognition Award winner. She's a Silver Cord recipient, a National Honor Society member, and Chloe will be attending the University of Northwestern St. Paul to study kinesiology and to play softball. and it is my pleasure to also introduce to the stage valedictorian Ryan Jamison. In addition to receiving a perfect 4.0 GPA, Ryan has also managed to earn over 35 DMAT credits, which will allow her to start school next year classified as a sophomore. She is a Silver Cord recipient, our chairperson of the school blood drive the last 2 years. She's vice president of our student council and a varsity captain in softball and basketball. Ryan will be attending DMAC in Boone next year to complete her RN and then plans to transfer to a four-year university. Please let me start by welcoming Chloe, Mackenzie, and Ryan to the stage.
Good afternoon, class of 2022, and to the family and friends that are accompanying us in their support. Parents, what a relief it must be to be sitting here today knowing that your child has finally made it to this milestone in their life. My commitments go to you for your efforts to put up with your child for 4 years of high school and for your endless support in all of their endeavors. Mom and Dad, I'm sorry if it's been a long 4 years. I also would like to say a huge thank you to all the staff and teachers that have helped us reach this point in our lives. Thank you for making our brains swell during the day, the endless nights of homework, and late hours studying for tests we thought we'd fail. It's only prepared us to be successful in the future. Thank you to my classmates that I get to walk this stage, and I couldn't be more elated to be standing here in front of you all today. Now, I know many of you sitting in front of me are very overwhelmed with senioritis, so bear with me as you listen to a couple more speeches. We are a class of excellence, and you should all congratulate yourselves on your accomplishments. I want to reflect on your journey over the years as we have evolved into young men and women. As a class, we have 48 out of 59 of us involved in one activity, and 28 out of 59 of us involved in two or more activities. Do you all remember packing your lunch boxes to take to a track meet that you wouldn't get home from until 11 p.m., or cleaning and packing your instrument for a concert, or whatever sport you are in? You are a student athlete. We've made it this far, and look at the mark that you have left on Woodward Granger Athletics. We might have not brought home a state title, but we remain consistent and passionate about our sporting events. As a class, I can also proudly say that there was a great handful of us at sporting events to cheer on our fellow classmates and other students, even if we weren't the ones playing or participating. This goes to show the spirit our class has to support one another and all of our doings is unbelievable and should not go unnoticed. At the start of our careers as students, many of us did not know where we wanted to go, what we wanted to pursue, or even what we wanted to eat that day for lunch. Now we have classmates going to serve our country and across the states to Delaware, Arizona, South Dakota, and all over Iowa pursuing their passion. I'd like to say how proud I am of all of you for your hard work to this point. Now it's time to take on the world and continue your passion. Gabriella Bernstein described it the best. Allow your passion to become your purpose, and it will one day become your profession. When thinking of descriptive words to describe this class, I couldn't think of anything better than passionate. One thing our class excels in is pursuing the things we're passionate about. Katie Bennett is going to a D1 school for competitive horse riding. Hunter Keebler and Don David are going to serve our country. And we have multiple of us who are going into the healthcare field and have already started our career as nursing assistants. We even have successful students who are going straight into the workforce. Talk about being very passionate. We are all diverse in our areas of interest, which I believe makes our class very well-rounded. We're also passionate about community service. We've had the most students receive Silver Cords for volunteerism this year than any class has in the past few years. Many of us even helped clean up the community after a derecho hit our town or mowed neighborhood yards on a regular basis growing up. Our passion only continues. We had abundance of students in our top 15% and 4 valedictorians, which I'm pleased to be standing here with the two of you today. But reflect back on you. Think about all the things you have done for Woodward Granger. Just Friday night, the baccalaureate committee members put on a lovely ceremony before the awards presentation. We have even started the Safe School Driving Program, being only the 3rd school in Iowa to do so. Not to mention all the advisory competitions we had to raise the most items to donate to nursing and veterans homes and those in need in the community. We even fought through a pandemic starting spring of our sophomore year and various administrative changes. While being passionate might be a good word to describe my class, I think you should add resilience in as well. I want to end by describing how I got here today as one of the class leaders. When I lost my grandma Shirley and Uncle Bob to cancer, and my mom was diagnosed with breast cancer, it was a very stressful year, to say the least. But my mom gave me a book called The Coffee Bean by John Gordon. The main takeaway that I got from the book that I want you guys to remember when you walk out of those doors today is to always be a coffee bean when faced with adversity. The world outside of high school is going to smack some of us right in the face. It's reality. And we can't be soft like a carrot gets when it gets put in a hot pan of water, or hard and stubborn like an egg gets when it gets put in water. Unfortunately, we do get angry, mean, and negative sometimes, but I want you to all grow in the environments you pursue after high school. Take those unfortunate circumstances at college or work and turn them into a lesson. Don't weaken or crack under pressure, but be the coffee bean that turns boiling water into coffee. Y'all have been passionate this far in your endeavors and towards Woodward Granger, so make it your life mission to continue to do so. Class of 2022, take some time to congratulate yourselves and celebrate how far you've made it, but don't forget to say a sincere thank you to all of those supporters who have helped you along the way.
As we all know, these past 4 years have not been easy, and we've experienced a lot of trying times. From dealing with a national pandemic sophomore year that gave us an extended spring break, to returning in the fall to uncertainty and not knowing if we were able to go in person to school or still be able to have various sports and activities. Our school has also seen major changes in staff and administration in the past few years, which have impacted the way Woodward Granger prepares students for life after high school. The new motto created was WG Building Futures, and looking at my own classmates, I know we've succeeded in fulfilling that calling. Our class is full of hardworking and passionate individuals that have overcome so many roadblocks throughout their years of schooling. From learning how to face challenge head on, to throwing ourselves into opportunity at full steam ahead, the class of 2022 is resilient. I want to take this opportunity to thank my parents for being the best role models of grace, humility, strength, and love for me the past 18 years. I wouldn't be standing here today without their steadfast support and never-ending love that helped me through some of the most trying years of my life. To my class, we will all continue to face adversity and hard times in the future, so be active in making light of situations and don't let anyone tell you your potential. And don't forget to thank and remember the special people who helped you along the way to your successes. Thank you.
To quote Scottish writer Henry Drummond, the people who influence you are the people who believe in you. As I stand before so many people who have influenced my life today, I would like to say thank you. Thank you to the teachers and administration who pushed my classmates and I to a higher standard. To the coaches who instilled the importance of teamwork and dedication into our athletes. And thank you to the Woodward Granger community for showing myself and my classmates nothing but love and support throughout the years. Most importantly, I'd like to thank my biggest inspirations in life, Dad, Mom, Riley, and Reese. Thank you for all of the support and unconditional love you have shown me. I truly would not be the person I am today without all of you. Classmates, as you sit and think about who has influenced you during your life, I hope you find the courage to be this influence for somebody else. No matter what path you choose in the next chapter of your life, you have the ability to impact others in a positive way. This will look different for each and every one of you. Your influence is not limited to the words spoken, but your actions and the examples that you set. We are the future. As you go into the world, set expectations and make a difference. Be the change you wish to see. You are all more than capable. As I leave here today, I'd like to challenge you. Appreciate each moment as they come. Do not miss the present waiting for the future. Help your neighbors along the way, as it will not slow your pace. Find the things and the people who bring you joy and hold them close. Lastly, do not forget how precious life is. Say I love you and hug your loved ones often. As you transition into the next chapter of your life, I hope that you live a life you are proud of. If you find yourself in a time of struggle, I hope you find the courage to push forward. Class of 2022, the days were long, but the years were short. We did it. I wish you nothing but luck in your future endeavors. Thank you, and as always, go Hawks.
As these three ladies have just proven, our personal journeys are something to be recognized and celebrated. And one of my favorite traditions here at WG, it's my privilege to now honor 7 graduates and their families for their longstanding commitment to Woodward Granger Community School District. These 7 students will be the 3rd, 4th, and even 5th generation of their families to graduate from our high school, and that distinction should not go unnoticed. To commemorate this amazing commitment to our school district, we have created a customized piece of artwork to recognize each family's lineage. The image of a hawk flying across the sky represents each family's distinct ties to our school. Their last name, painted on the hawk's back, is symbolic of their family's loyalty. Truly, they are the backbone of this institution. And each family member's name and graduation year is inscribed below the image to recognize how, just like each small feather on a bird may blend into the greater whole, each graduate, in their own right, has contributed a great deal to building the strong institution we see today. Our first family is represented by Kylie Limoge. Kylie's mother, Kathy, graduated in 1989. And Kylie's grandfather, Gordon, graduated in the class of 1969. Our next family is represented by Kaysen Bice. Kaysen's mother, Nicole, graduated in 1997, and Kaysen's grandparents, Rick and Joanne, graduated in the class of 1975 and 77, respectively. Our next family is represented by Lucas Hansen. Lucas' father, Christopher Jr., graduated in 1990, and his grandfather, Christopher Sr., graduated in 1969. Our next family is represented by Hunter Keebler. Hunter's father, Nicholas, graduated in 2003, and his grandfather, Jake, graduated in 1978. Next up is Sophie Cavanaugh. Sophie's father, Matt, graduated in 1997. Her grandfather, Kenny, graduated in 1975. Sophie's great-grandmother, Doris, graduated in 1942. And her great-great-grandmother, Myrtle, graduated in 1922. Our next family is represented by Ryan Jameson. Ryan's mother, Jody, and father, Dan, graduated in 1985 and 78. Her grandparents, Janice and Mike, graduated in 1964 and 63, respectively. And 3 of her great-grandparents, Martha, Ruth, and Howard, graduated in the classes of 1943 and 39. Finally, Jaden Smeltzer is following his father, Dave, from the class of 1992. And his mother, Brandy, from the class of 1996. And all 4 of his grandparents, Jerry, Dennis, Martha, and Connie, graduated in 1973, 74, and 76, respectively. His great-grandfathers, Ray and John, also graduated in the class of 1944 and 1930. There are so many success stories within this group, probably too many to fully acknowledge. However, I would like to take a moment to honor a few individual achievements of our students. Students, would you please rise if you are a member of this year's Student Council? These students are signified with a purple cord. You may be seated. Students, please rise if you are an honorary blood donor. These students have donated blood 3 or more times this school year alone and are signified with a red cord. Please rise if you have earned a DMAC certificate while attending high school. They are signified with a blue and white cord. Please rise if you are a member of our National Honor Society. National Honor Society members are signified with an NHS stole. please rise if you are in the top 15% of your class? Students in the top 15% of their class academically are signified with a gold cord. And please rise if you have earned your silver cord for over 140 hours of community service while in high school. You may be seated. What you've all accomplished throughout high school is amazing, and we are incredibly proud in each and every one of you. Thank you for your hard work, thank you for your service, and your commitment to not just bettering yourself, but the community around you. And if we look to the past to recognize our accomplishments, I believe it's also important that we look to the future. So, if you have chosen to serve in our armed forces after graduation, would you please stand so we may thank you for choosing to serve our country? Please stay standing. If you plan to pursue an apprenticeship or a trades program next year, would you please stand? If you plan to enroll into a 4 or 2 year college next year, would you please stand? And if you plan to go straight into the workforce and immediately become a contributing member of society, would you please stand to be recognized? All of you, it's amazing. All of you have dreams, all of you have direction. Just remember that no matter what path you choose, you are always a Woodward Granger Hawk, and we are proud of you. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to present the salutatorian for the class of 2022. The salutatorian distinction is given to the student with the second highest ranking in their class. It's my honor to call Katie Grell to the stage. And as I've already mentioned, in what has been a banner year for our graduating class, I would now like to honor all four of our valedictorians. Mackenzie Dresbeck, Chloe Hoag, Ryan Jameson, and Caitlin Smith. Would you please come to the stage? All four of these students have received a GPA of 4.0 or higher and have represented the class of 2022 wonderfully. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you our fourth and final valedictorian, Caitlin Smith. Caitlin has received a perfect 4.02 weighted GPA, but as talented in the classroom as she is, her dance moves are just as impressive. 15 years in studio dance, 4 years in our high school program, she undoubtedly excelled in the arts, participating in jazz band, show choir, drama, and speech. She's a National Honor Society member and an All-State Speech Contest Award winner. Caitlin will attend UNI next year to study psychology and criminal justice with an honors distinction. Please welcome to the podium, Caitlin Smith.
Thank you to administration, staff, family, and friends. Thank you to my friends and family who have encouraged me to become the best version of myself. Thank you to the teachers who have supported me while also pushing me to test my limits. And finally, to my parents, for driving me before I got my school permit to the countless activities I was attempting to partake in one day. Thank you. Class of 2022, after 6 years of elementary, 3 years of middle school, and 4 years of high school, we're finally here. And we're gonna walk across this stage in less than 30 minutes. We've gone through a lot, but we've also grown, and we've become the people we are today. We're stronger, more adaptable, and let's be honest, we're ready to get out of this place and become an actual adult. High school has been interesting, with many ups and downs, new people, new experiences, and a very long and interesting spring break in 2020. But throughout all the difficulty, we've grown, we've developed, we've learned, and we're finally beginning to come into who we are. But what does that mean? How does one know what being yourself is? Bear with me. According to Google, identity is defined as the fact of being who or what a person or thing is. Now, I don't know about you, but that definition sounds like something an English teacher would say. Oh, sorry, love you, Mrs. Buck. So the definition doesn't work for our intents and purposes. What about something different? When trying to answer this question, I went to YouTube. I found crash courses, videos with different theories, and nothing that really worked. Eventually, I happened upon a lecture by Jordan Peterson, a psychology professor at the University of Toronto. The basic idea went something like this. Identity is the group that you agree to the terms and conditions of. You agree to the morals, values, opinions, taboos, beliefs of the group. For example, we are American. We believe in patriotism, the Constitution, freedom of speech, our education, and most importantly, football. Those values and beliefs are our identity. It's what makes us American. Sadly, in our society, identity is a big and controversial issue. Thanks to technology and social media, no longer are we only communicating within our small communities, like they would have in the 1900s, or only hearing about a country from the radio, like they would have in the 1900s. Now, we can be friends with someone halfway across the world, and another country's problem can very easily become our own, too. We all live different lives. We all have different morals, values, beliefs. We all have different identities. Now, the trick is understanding what identity is or that it exists in our lives, but to respect it. No matter who you are, conservative or liberal, black or white, woman or man, straight or gay, young or old, we are all human. We all have morals, values, beliefs. We all have different identities. Class of 2022, in a few moments, we will officially be Woodward Granger alumni. We will be adults going out into the world. No matter where you go, what you do, when you go, how you do it, why, I challenge you to not look past the terms and conditions, but to read closely. Be yourself, and please respect others. As my mom likes to say, you don't have to hang out or do the hula with them. You just have to respect them. Thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin. Every year, our seniors are asked to vote for a WG staff member to speak at their commencement ceremony. I personally don't know why you all chose a man that clearly is going to spend the next 5 to 10 minutes roasting all of you. But hey, teach their own. His agent informed me this morning that all autographs and photo ops will take place in the Commons following today's ceremony. Next to the stage, I would like to introduce a man that likely needs no introduction in this district, a person I proudly call a colleague and a friend, Mr. Matt Bruman.
I woke up this morning and the first thing I said to my wife was, "Are you coming this afternoon to the graduation ceremony?" Her quick response was, "How long's your speech?" I was like, what the heck? She's here, so apparently the time limit will meet her guidelines. Woodward Granger, class of 2022, parents, families, colleagues, and everyone that is present today to support this brilliant group of young people, it is an honor to speak with you today. For most of you that know me, you're probably thinking, oh God, what's gonna come out of Mr. Bruman's mouth? Or more importantly, how long is it gonna take? If you had the pleasure of watching me during COVID, you know that I can ramble on for a minimum of 30 minutes without topic or direction. So Caitlin, that 30-minute guarantee of walking across the stage, we might be pushing it. Mr. Moline, Mrs. Moss, Mr. Eichhorner behind me, for sure betting on how long it's gonna take or if I'm gonna cry. Probably have an over-under on both. Mr. Lakis is sitting behind me wringing his hands, just hoping that I am timely so that I don't screw up his schedule. And Dr. Adams, although he is leaving us, is behind reflecting on the best and most challenging 3 years of his educational career. So sit back, everyone, pop some popcorn, relax, and enjoy the inspiration. We can't have inspiration without a little bit of reflection. Class of 2022, 8 years ago, I was in my first year at Woodward Granger. Most of you were my fifth graders. Kenzie, you came to us. That was your first year here with us as a fifth grader. Nick, I think you came to us as a fifth grader that year. Mr. Harney, I gave you and your mom a personal tour to make sure that Woodward Granger was going to be where you were going to land the rest of your life, and here you sit today. We all loaded a bus and came to this gym that fall to celebrate homecoming with all of the students from Woodward Granger. I grabbed my then kindergartners, they're now teenagers. Blows my mind, 13 years old now. I made them stand across the then seniors and I said, enjoy the ride because it will go fast. You were the big kids of the elementary that year. Now look at you. What you didn't understand then, I hope you do now. I mean, let's just think about that first year. Two out of the three fifth grade teachers were brand new, Ms. Hunneke, Ms. Winkle. Two of you were out in a portable. Two of your classrooms were out in a portable behind the ELC building. All 500 students were crammed into that one little building. There was no new building. It was being built that year. And by the way, that new building is 7 years old now, so quit calling it the new building. We did the wildly popular ice bucket challenge out in the front parking lot. Mr. Bird, I believe you were in charge of dumping the ice over my head that day. A very slow pour, might I remind you. We had our first ever Iowa versus Iowa State cheers / scream off in the gym. So loud. I mean, Hunter, you started the year with 10 fingers. You ended with 9.5. And you were still able to swing the baseball bat that summer for the home runs. Hannah, I believe you broke your leg that year. You were on my shoulders when we were down at the Hy-Vee Hall for that, again, ridiculously loud fourth and fifth grade character counts assembly where every fourth and fifth grader in the metro attended. Sam Pittman, you were elected BizTown mayor that year. So your future in politics started early. You sit next to Easy Eddie, Fast Eddie Phillips. That's all I'm gonna say right there. That's all I'm gonna say, Ed. I let you sit where you wanted at lunch where I learned most of your names. I learned that Lucas Hansen, where's Lucas, had an affinity for comfortable footwear and sweatpants. He graduated from Crocs and is now to the Hey Dude, so I can appreciate that. I now have them both thanks to your inspiration. Thank you, Lucas. Alex Evans was quick to share some deer jerky and protein with me. Whatever he had hanging in the garage, he brought with him to school on a Monday afternoon. So I appreciate the protein, buddy. Thank you. Don and I would talk about the Packers. Nate and Peyton would constantly, they would sit at the end of the lunchroom table and try to, they were convinced I did not know their names. But if you go back and look at their fifth grade photos, girl sisters, I'm sorry, you were not the only twins in fifth grade. You look back at your fifth grade photo, you look nothing like you do now, but in fifth grade, twins, look it up. Darby, Ryan, Katie, Sid, Brayton, Chloe, Alex, all of you girls, and a few others were constantly trying to convince me that this class was always going to be my favorite at WG. They went into junior high, we're still your favorite. High school, we're still your favorite. In reflection, I can't say yes yet, because I have a few more years to go, but you were definitely an inspiring bunch and brought joy and a smile to my life each and every day, so for that, I say thank you. Now to the inspiration and thought-provoking moments that someone will record, post on social media, and I will become wildly popular and end up on a worldwide speaking tour by the end of the summer. Nobody? Phones. Okay. So you're sitting there asking yourself, where would Mr. Brumman find such inspiration? And I kind of feel bad after listening to the valedictorians and everything, the quoting famous authors and books. I'm not going to lie, I'm meeting you where you're at as young adults. To find the great thinkers of the world, I didn't go to any books. I went to YouTube and TikTok. My TikTok feed has gone from giggling babies, which I can appreciate, there was a giggling baby up here earlier, adorable puppies, shenanigans, Blackstone and Traeger recipes, to quotes and statements that just make me reflect and think about life and what's ahead for you. So here are my top thought bombs for you as you author the next chapter of your life, and I themed them accordingly. Judgment. The great Ted Lasso. For those of you that don't know Ted Lasso or The Office, some of you are going to be lost in the next few minutes. The great Ted Lasso quoted Walt Whitman, "Be curious, not judgmental." Carl Jung once stated, "Thinking is difficult. That's why most people judge." Class of 2022, in a world of constant judgment, likes, and views, take the time to ask the questions. Get to know people. Understand their story. Grow the relationship and leave the judging to the non-thinkers. Character. The great UCLA basketball coach John Wooden, "It is our choices that show who we truly are far more than our abilities. Doing the right thing is never the wrong thing. Every choice is a chance." Class of 22. This hasn't changed since preschool and will probably be the final thing your parents say to you tonight before you head out to that final grad party. Make good choices. Hard work. Matthew McConaughey of All Right, All Right, All Right, that guy, great thinker, says, "Life is not easy. It's not. Don't try to make it that way. Life's not fair. It never was. It isn't now, and it won't ever be. Do not fall into the trap, the entitlement trap, of feeling like you're a victim. You're not. Get over it, get on with it, and yes, most things are more rewarding when you break a sweat to get them." Denzel Washington says, "Without goals, dreams are just dreams, and they ultimately fuel disappointment. So have dreams, but have goals. Life goals, yearly goals, monthly goals, daily goals, everyday goals, something simple, but have goals. But understand, to achieve those goals, you must apply discipline and consistency. Dreams don't work unless you do." Class of 2022, reach that level of passion when someone will not understand why you work so hard. Do not dare settle for fine. You all have so much more in front of you than to settle for fine. Time. When asked, "What's the biggest mistake we make in life?" the Buddha replied, "The biggest mistake is you think you have time. Time is free, but it's priceless. You can't own it, but you can use it. You can't keep it, but you can't spend it, but you can spend it. And once it's lost, you never get it back." Think about this. If you wake up every day with $84,600 in your bank account, and every day at the end of the night, it's gone, whether you wasted it or not, and the next day you get another $84,600 in your bank account, you would do everything in your power to spend it. Because the next day you're getting another $84,600. You don't want to leave anything there. you'd make the best of it, right? You get 84,600 seconds every day. Why waste time? Make the best of it. Class of 2022, there are only two people in the world that you need to make proud. It's not your mom. It's not your dad. Not your future husband, not your future wife, not your future kids. It's the 8-year-old version of you and the 80-year-old version of you. If those two people are happy with the way you've lived your life, it means you did everything right. Grit. I have a quote here from Rocky Balboa, and in my notes it says, "Do the voice." I will spare you that. That is not gonna happen. I'm not doing the voice, Hunter, sorry. Rocky Balboa once stated in one of his famous movies, and I apologize for the grammar, "Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't how hard you hit, or how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward, that's how winning is done. If you don't know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not point fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or nobody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that." Now I need a little participation. When I point to you, say, "Keep showing up." It's pretty simple, okay? I don't need anybody else, just you 60 right in front of me. Keep showing up. If no one invests in you, invest in yourself. If no one believes in you, believe in yourself. Even if you don't see the results right away, until you do see the results. Even if you don't see the results for a very long time, what if the results don't come? They're not gonna come if you quit. "I'm tired. I don't feel like it. I can't see the results. I don't know where to start. Just start. Do something. Take that first step. Every step you take adds up. Keep showing up." Class of 2022, it's okay to not be okay. It's just not okay to stay that way. Life. Kevin Hart, I'm not gonna do his voice either, says, "All right, you got one life, and that one life, the goal for us is to live it to the best of our ability from the beginning to what's said is the end. In the beginning, middle, you're gonna do things, you're gonna make mistakes, and you're gonna screw up. You're supposed to learn and then move forward with the understanding of what not to do. And when you move forward, life may get better, it may not, but somewhere along the lines it's gonna click and everything that I went through back when then was supposed to happen. So now that I'm here, I'm able to go ahead with such a high level of knowledge that I can help make other people better, I can make myself better, I can do more for my family, my friends, something just happens." Class of 22, anything that annoys you is teaching you patience. Anyone who abandons you is teaching you how to stand on your own two feet. Anything that angers you is teaching you forgiveness and compassion. Anything that has power over you is teaching you how to take your power back. Anything you hate is teaching you unconditional love. Anything you fear is teaching you courage to overcome your fear. Anything you can't control is teaching you how to let go. Everything in life is teaching you something. Now I'm gonna end with my top three thinkers of all time. The first one, Dwight Schrute from The Office. Dwight simply says, and these are the three that I need you to walk away from today, locked and loaded and ready to go. Dwight says, "Whenever I'm about to do something, I think, would an idiot do that? And if they would, I do not do that thing." Our very own Ashton Kutcher, and this is a quote, Ashton Kutcher, down the road, 70s show fame, The Ranch, many other things. He's a thinker. Everyone around us that we call life was made up by people that are no smarter than you. And you can build your own things, you can build your own life that other people can live in. So build a life, don't live one. Find your opportunities and always be sexy. He said it, I'm just repeating it. And finally, Ted Lasso says, you know what the happiest animal on earth is? It's a goldfish. You know why? It's got a 10-second memory. Be a goldfish. Class of 2022, your life is a book, your life has chapters, each chapter of your life is a punctuation, whether it's a positive or a negative. And before you move on to the next chapter, you have a decision to make. If I'm going to correct what I did in the chapter before. Ultimately, when you get to the end of the book, it's written by you. Congratulations, class of 2022. I love you. I'm proud of you. Now go write the next chapter and light the world on fire. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bruman. Graduates, you chose a white rose to symbolize your graduating class. A white rose represents youthfulness and loyalty, which is quite a fitting representation of your group. And before we close this chapter and begin anew, I would like each of you to think about someone who has impacted your life. Someone like Mr. Bruman. Someone who has demonstrated immense loyalty and commitment to your success. Someone that was with you through thick and thin. They are one of the main reasons you are here today, and now it is time to let them know. Graduates, would you please stand and present the person with your class flower, a white rose? Not a dry eye in the house. I would now like to call to the stage our superintendent of Woodward Granger Community Schools, Dr. Matt Adams.
Well, that's just a blink of the eye. I just have to stop, and that video just is very touching. It's like a blink of an eye. Well, good afternoon, everybody. I'm grateful to be here today to honor our graduating class for their tremendous accomplishments. Seniors, I hope this year was filled with excitement as you considered all the possibilities this special year of school has to offer. And I hope you took advantage of the wonderful opportunities that come with this special time and that it was everything you wanted it to be. If your high school experience has taught us anything, it would be that life is full of challenges. You showed grit and the ability to pivot when confronted with adversity. The uncertainty of your circumstances didn't impede progress, and you persevered. The ability to adapt and overcome any situation will serve you well, regardless of your next pursuit. Difficulties, failure, or opposition should never slow you down. Be relentless in your continued effort to achieve your goals. What you can accomplish is limitless and entirely up to you. All of you can be a positive influence on this world. You just need to get active and get involved. What are you passionate about? I want you to harness that passion and find ways to share it with the rest of the world. It's amazing what can be accomplished when you are fully invested. Be a contributor and make a difference for others. Watch for your chance and take advantage of the opportunity when it presents itself. There is plenty of room for you to make an impact. I challenge you to continue to find your voice and speak up. We want to hear from you. Share your perspective and express your views. But always be willing to listen so you're exposed to varying viewpoints. Seek first to understand and then be understood. Great communicators are also great listeners. Be an independent thinker. Be ready to ask questions and make sense of the world around you. There is so much information right at your fingertips. I want you to wonder, analyze, and access this steady stream of information to draw conclusions and solve complex problems. Be curious and listen to multiple perspectives. From there, you can determine how you see the world. You live in a world that is dynamic and constantly changing. We need you to challenge the status quo and be ready to find answers to questions we haven't even asked yet. Be creative and use your imagination to help solve problems with cutting-edge solutions. Someone has to solve new and existing problems. Why can't it be you? By definition, commencement actually means a beginning or a start. Consider all the new possibilities that have opened up to you after today. Your presence in this ceremony represents years of hard work and dedication to building a strong foundation for a successful future. But I know you didn't do it alone. Students, would you join me in thanking your parents and teachers for all the love, time, energy they poured into you? I'm proud of you, and I'm proud of what you've accomplished. So it's easy for me to say, ladies and gentlemen, President Brandt, members of the Board of Education, as superintendent of Woodward Granger Schools, I verify these students have successfully fulfilled requirements set forth by the Woodward Granger Board of Education and State of Iowa. Therefore, the students seated before us today are eligible to receive their diplomas, which is symbolic of this achievement.
At this time, would the members of the class of 2022 please come forward to be recognized? Jordan David Andrews. Brayton Mikkel Ashman. Corbin James Atwell. Katie Lynn Bennett. Kaysen Joyanne Bice. Dylan Thomas Bird. Elena Bortot. Eberly Susan Irene Brim. Claire Delaney Britton. Taylor Elena Buckman. Sophie Carol Cavanaugh. Donald Andrew David. Erica Lynn Delp. Peyton George Drake. Mackenzie Blair Dresbeck. Alex Luke Evans. Nicholas Michael Firstenow. Jordan Marie Gabriel. Ashton Ray Ann Gates. Ashley Kate Gherkin. Catherine Ann Grell. Sydney Joe Grell. Parker Dean Griffin. Bailey Elaine Hansen. Lucas Christopher Hansen. Dustin Jeffrey Harney. Joel Robert Harney. Olivia Caroline Horsch. Chloe Ann Hogue. Cole Robert James. Ryan Elizabeth Jamison. Hunter Lee Keebler. Braden Scott King. Jacob Gray Lego. Kylie Ann Limoges. Macy Widling Lyle. Madison Lynn Mann. Devin Randall McNear. Alexandra D. Mehrhoff. Jack Douglas Musburger. Hannah Marie Miller. Nathan William Mosier. Darby Paris Nixon. Annabella Nichelle Pauly Deleon. Edward Marion Phillips Jr. Samuel Lyle Pittman. Jackson Donald Potter. Olivia Grace Romero. Dylan Michael Rogers. Bailey Lynn Rubendahl. Alexia Ann Segovia. Shakazad Shodiv. Rebecca Violet Seams. Jaden Ray Smeltzer. Caitlin Joe Smith. Samantha James Voles. Brennan Michael Wilson. Mary Elizabeth Woodard. Austin Nicole Ziegenmeier.
Students, to signify your graduation, will you please move your tassel from right to left? Members of the board, Superintendent Adams, ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I present to you the WG High School Class of 2022. Thank you all for coming. We appreciate your support and all of the love that you've given to our students. Students in the first row.
She was staring out the window of their SUV, plain and saying, I can't wait to turn 18. Said I'll make my own money and I'll make my own rules. Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school. And she kissed her head and said I was just like you. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. Some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this.
Hey, I need to
before she knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place. She says it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies, buying a house. Betty shakes his head.